Let's begin. Beautiful yogis. So this week is all about grounding to the earth. A little bit of science to back that up. Got some cords hanging out of my pants. I don't know if you've ever heard this, but the premise of just going outside and walking barefoot, or you know, if you've ever walked on the beach, you've probably noticed that you just feel better. So when you don't have shoes or pavement in between your feet and the actual ground, something happens where you ground yourself out. We have these electrical charges running through our body, and everything we touch throughout the course of the day also has a charge. And so we acquire more electrical charges and give them off. And by just connecting to the earth, it starts to clear out these energy channels in the body. And they've done these studies where there's more blood flow throughout the brain after, I don't know, around like 20 minutes of walking on the beach, which is crazy. So if you can get outside barefoot, no shoes, on grass or the sand, that is ideal. If you can't, this very number one yoga pose that you learn, Tadasana, standing mountain pose, is, you know, the center of grounding out. So we'll do that today by just planting our feet underneath our hips. And if you can do this outside, rock on, even better. I know it's hard when you live, you know, on the second floor or whatever. But just feeling the ground underneath your feet can feel very supportive as well. So we'll soften into the knees here, find those feet right underneath the hips, push down into the heels. Oh, one other thing I forgot, this grounding out also, it slows your heart rate down and decreases blood pressure. Who knew? That idea of just connecting to nature quite literally really does have an effect on your body. So get away from your computer and find Tadasana either, you know, outside, or if you can't, just inside on your mat. So we'll ground down into the feet. Feel the tailbone tuck underneath you. Feel the belly hug in a little bit. Feel the heels and the balls of the feet. You can even pick up your toes a little to feel the balls of the feet connect. Soft little bend in the knees so you're not locking them. Roll the palms out. Feel the, it's like you're trying to separate your ribs from your hips. You're lifting up with your rib cage. Shoulder blades tuck together. Poof out the heart. Lengthen through the back of the neck. Let the tips of the ears reach up towards the sky. And then soften the shoulders. Soften the jaw. Soften the mask of your face. Breathe. Let your breath drop past the ribs, through the solar plexus, all the way down into the belly, like your breath could drop through the tailbone, through the legs, and go all the way down into the floor. Feel the connection to the earth, but also the connection to the sky. So there's a lightness in the crown of the head, in the forehead, in the heart. And can you find a balance between the back and the front body? We're such a forward-leading culture. We want to lean into everything, but that back body is our support as well. It's our past, our history. It's where we come from. So breathe into the back of the ribs. Breathe into the back of the lungs and the back of the waist. Imagine you could breathe into the back of your neck, every pore on the back of your neck, opening up here with your breath. Maybe close your eyes. Feel your standing Tadasana mountain pose. Let yourself feel connected to not only earth, but this universal pulse of energy. Let it flow into you, and reversely, let it flow right back out of you. Send it right back out. then maybe here, turn the corners of your mouth up, smile. Feel your breath taking on this light quality. And I don't just mean not heavy, I mean brightness as well. Like you're filling yourself up with a brightness. So you're half floating, half grounded, and you rest, and the heart rests somewhere right in the middle. And we can carry that presence with us everywhere we go, right? It's how you walk, it's how you enter a room. It's how you show up for people. It's how you show up for yourself. So thank you so much. That is our little pose of the day, our little science and how yoga works for the week. I will see you next Monday. Take the day off tomorrow. Check in on Sunday with the newsletter about what our new dharma and theme of next week will be. See you next time. Namaste.